In this video, we're looking at some velocity time data for an experiment in the lab. So on the vertical axis, I have velocity in meters per second. On the horizontal axis, I have the time in seconds. We're told that the grid spacing here is 0.5 meters per second per space in the vertical direction and 0.2 seconds in the horizontal direction. And we've presumably collected some data using a motion sensor here. And then we've applied a best fit line to that data. And what we're trying to do here is estimate the displacement of the cart that was moving with this VT data, and then estimate the acceleration of the cart. So we just have to remember that the displacement is given by the area bounded by the VT graph. And this best fit line has given us a simple triangle for the area. And the height of that triangle is 2.0 meters per second, while the base of that triangle is 1.8 seconds. So we have to be careful about counting the grid spaces here. 1.0 seconds is labeled in the graph, and then we have another 0.2, 0.4, 0.6, and 0.8. So the base is 1.8 seconds. When we get the area of that triangle, I have 1/2 times the base, 1.8 seconds, times the height, 2.0 meters per second. And the twos are going to cancel here, and I end up with 1.8. And then look what happens to the units. The seconds cancel, and I end up with meters for my estimated displacement. In part B, we want to estimate the acceleration during this experiment. And we remember the acceleration is given by the slope of the velocity time graph, which is a constant here. Really, I should say we're talking about an average acceleration over the given time interval, but it is constant. And that's given by our change in velocity over the change in time, the vertical change over the horizontal change. We've already written these into the graph, and that's 2.0 meters per second for the change in velocity. We went from 0 to 2. And 1.8 seconds for the change in time. We went from a time of 0 to a time of 1.8. When we take 2.0 divided by 1.8, we'll just keep three sig figs here. I get 1.11. And then look at the units. Meters per second divided by seconds gives me meters per second squared. And that's it. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left. Or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.